This episode of DNews was proudly made possible by the all-new 2015 Subaru Legacy. It's not just a sedan, it's a Subaru. Everyone is up in arms about Ebola, but what about the enterovirus? Is that an even bigger threat to our nation's health? Hey guys, Tara here for DNews, and there's been a lot of media coverage lately about all kinds of diseases. Ebola, the flu, and now enterovirus. A four-year-old boy in New Jersey died in his sleep a couple weeks ago, making it the first reported case of death caused by Enterovirus D68. So what is the enterovirus, and should we be worried about it? Well, believe it or not, Enterovirus D68 is just one of over 100 different strains of enterovirus, the most famous one being poliovirus. According to the CDC, the US sees about 10 to 15 million cases of enterovirus every year, usually peaking around the end of summer and early fall. The EV-D68 strain, though, is a relatively uncommon form. Over the past 50 years, it's been responsible for fewer than 100 cases of enterovirus. So the reason it's receiving so much attention this year is because of the sheer amount of cases of it and the number of hospitalizations it's caused. So far, more than 43 states have reported cases of the D68 virus. Symptoms of enterovirus usually appear in the form of a bad summer cold, fever, runny nose, cough, and muscle aches are all indications of a mild infection. But D68 in particular has been linked to severe respiratory illness, and in some cases, even temporary paralysis. Children, and especially those with asthma, are particularly vulnerable because they haven't been exposed to the virus as much and thus haven't developed an immunity to it. Most of them also attend schools, which is a very easy way to pass anything around. Unfortunately, since there's really no cure or vaccine for D68, the best method of treatment is really prevention. The CDC is recommending that everyone reduce their exposure by washing their hands with soap and water for 20 seconds, keeping their hands away from their face, and avoiding people who are sneezing or coughing. In the event your child does become ill over the next few months, then there's probably no reason to worry. But if they start exhibiting respiratory problems or showing signs of extreme muscle weakness, then the CDC says you should contact a doctor immediately. Of course, the silver lining here, and the one thing you should remember if your child does get sick, is that enterovirus usually isn't deadly, which means the case of the boy in New Jersey appears to be an extreme outlier. What do you guys think about this? And are you more worried about enterovirus or about Ebola? Let us know your answers in the comments below. And as always, thanks for watching.